Hey, what's up? Alex here. The video that I got the most requests for an update from you guys is the one that I gave my review of 7 smart home platforms. That was done way back in May 2021 and a lot has changed since then. So what I have for you today is a more comprehensive evaluation review of 6 very popular smart home systems in the market today. They are Google Home with the public preview turned on, Amazon Alexa that is based in Singapore, Apple HomeKit with a Home Hub installed, Samsung SmartThings using their V3 Hub, Homey using their Homey Pro Hub, and Home Assistant using the Home Assistant Yellow. This time round, I have introduced 7 categories, and each of these categories was given a percentage based on how important I think they are, including some of the data I gathered from you guys from my recent poll. What's also different this time round is I had the opportunity to actually use and test out all of these smart home systems. So in a way, I feel that I'm in a much better position now doing this video to help you plan for your smart home setup. Before I begin, here's a quick word from today's sponsor. Surfshark VPN has always been my choice of my VPN provider. So why do I want a VPN? I use it the most to access content that's not available in Singapore, which is quite a lot, mostly games, YouTube, and Netflix shows. I believe this is also what most people use VPN for. What's uncommon and not a lot of people know about this is that some websites that sell goods and services are charging more based on your location. Simply switch to a different country and you got a cheaper price. Then of course, it has all the security features you need when you're traveling overseas using hotel Wi-Fi or airport Wi-Fi to access important sensitive information. Right now, they have a Christmas deal which comes with 5 extra months for free. On top of that, you can use Surfshark VPN on unlimited devices and also a 30 days money back guarantee. So use my code ALEXSTEEL to sign up now. First up, we look at the automation capabilities. From something basic like whether you can set triggers for sensors and buttons, able to create scenes, to something advanced like whether you can set condition checks, use loops, different types of triggers, and so on. For this category, Home Assistant is the best, although their scenes configuration is such a pain. Homey and Apple are very close runner-up. To do advanced automations for Homey, you can even log into their website and have access to a very interactive tool that allows you to configure advanced flows. For Apple, you have the Shortcuts app. Although Google Home now has this script editor for you to create your routines with added capabilities versus doing it over at the app, it's not working very well and still not fully able to do very basic things like using sensors and buttons as triggers. While Amazon can do some of these basic stuff very well, there isn't a tool available for you to do advanced automations. Next, for integrations, is to see how many device manufacturer companies these smart home platforms can support. The thing is, there are like hundreds or thousands of these companies. Impossible to test out everything. So what I'm going to do instead is to just evaluate based on my own smart home setup. So here is the list of what I use now. You can take a quick pause if you want. Google and Home Assistant score the highest here, while Apple and Homey are the lowest. By right, Matter should slowly resolve this problem, but looking at the current state of Matter, I'm not feeling very positive about it. For me, automation and integration are the two most important things I will consider. I really didn't expect such overwhelming votes for ease of use from the poll. Initially, I planned for about 15% here. But looking at the responses, I think I will increase it to 25%. There are a few things I consider under ease of use. Things like the UI interface, how easy it is to search and hide your devices, the dashboard controls, and basically how easy it is to figure out and understand the entire platform. Apple HomeKit tops this category. They are the only platform having a special Apple code to easily add devices into the Home app. The app is very clean, you know exactly where to look for your devices, dashboard looks good, and devices are easy to control. You can also easily download third-party apps from the Apple App Store to further enhance the experience. Google and Amazon are close behind Apple, both having a very similar user experience. Although Home Assistant is last in this category, I just want to say that it's actually not as complex as I thought. I really like that you can easily search and hide away devices that you don't need any interaction with. I feel that ease of use is something that can get better over time once you are more used to the system. For maintenance, we are looking at what is the effort required whenever there's a software update for the platform or firmware updates for the devices. Basically, the administrative work required to make sure that your smart home is always updated and working properly. So here comes one of the downsides of having devices connecting directly to the hub. Because these devices are not connected to their own manufacturer's hub, like for example, Acara devices to an Acara hub, you will end up not being able to update the firmware easily. So for that, Google and Amazon will score the highest in this category. Apple is slightly behind them because you still need to deal with iOS updates and there's no easy way to backup your HomeKit setup. At least Homey and Home Assistant are able to do backups, so SmartThings will have the lowest score here. To me, local control is not something I consider to be super important unless you're staying in places where internet connections are frequently down, but I still think it's necessary to be included as some of you do see it as better security. But note that local doesn't mean better performance. So Home Assistant, Apple and Homey have the highest score here. SmartThings, I would consider them to be half-half, then followed by Google and Amazon got zero in this category because they are run entirely on the cloud. Next, for cost, Google and Amazon are absolutely free. You don't really need the Google Nest hubs or the Amazon Echo devices at all. For Apple, realistically, you need either Apple TV or HomePod speaker, but at least the device itself is good. For SmartThings, the SmartThings station costs $60, but it's also a wireless charger and SmartThings button combined together, which I think is very value for money. The Homey Pro Hub does come with all the smart home protocols, very cool RGB lights, can double as an IR blaster, but the IR features are not very good and it costs $400. For Home Assistant, you will most likely set up with a Raspberry Pi or get a pre-installed appliance like the Home Assistant Yellow, which I got it at around $200. To remotely access Home Assistant, the supported and easiest way requires a subscription fee of about $6 per month. So both Homey and Home Assistant got the lowest in this category. I know many people will look at the cost. Actually, I do as well, but only during the very early days for me. Now, I wouldn't mind paying a little more if I know I'll be getting a very good system. I know it's hard not to consider the cost, but it shouldn't be a deciding factor when choosing your smart home system. For the last category, there are too many options. Initially, I wanted to put something like special features, whether it has any ecosystem-related advantage. I also consider community support. In the end, I decided to put it as company vision because it sort of encompasses everything, including the future roadmap and assessing the long-term usage of the system. For that, I'm giving the highest score to Home Assistant. It's one of the top open source projects. There are updates every week. The devs are very transparent sharing their plans, not to mention that there are literally so many YouTube videos and forum discussions from the community. Unfortunately, I couldn't say the same for SmartThings. Even Brian from the channel Automate Your Life has recently decided to move out of SmartThings. I'm quite upset over the whole removal of Groovy IDE and the H drivers implementations. Finally, now we have the overall results. After all the testing and score calculation, I conclude that the number one smart home system goes to the Apple HomeKit. A very close runner-up is Google Home, which is so easy to use and requires very little effort to maintain. Third place goes to Home Assistant, which has the best overall automation and integration capabilities. Just recently, Smart Home Solver, one of the biggest smart home channels, made a video to talk about which smart home systems to use. He separated them into two groups, the simple, user-friendly ones versus the complex but powerful ones. In order to get the best from both worlds, is to pick one system from each group and use them together. I 100% agree with this approach, so here are my recommendations for a 3-stage progressive setup depending on where you are currently in your smart home journey. For stage 1 is to go with something simple to start with. Option 1, Apple HomeKit, but if you're an Android phone user, then this is not an option. Option 2, Google Home. Option 3, if you really dislike Google, then go with Amazon Alexa, but only if you are based in US or Europe. For Asia, can forget about it. Some of the homes will stay at stage 1, and that's fine if you are looking for something basic. But if one day you want to do more, but are unable to do so because the platform is sort of holding you back, then it's time to move to stage 2. For option 1, HomeKit users, you already have good automation capabilities. All you need is to be able to integrate more devices. So you will want to add a home bridge or hoops to your setup. For option 2, existing Google Home users, you'll want to move out all your configurations to either SmartThings or Homey. Google Home will just be left with your voice commands and any other devices that you just can't integrate. For option 3, Alexa users, it will be something similar by introducing a hub-based solution like SmartThings or Homey, or automations to them. Alexa will be just your voice assistant. If you are currently at this stage now, you will know it once you hit that wall. That's when you should move to stage 3. At stage 3, you're going to remove whichever systems that you have added in stage 2 and replace that with Home Assistant. You're now very familiar with how a smart home works and what's available in the market, so you can even have a mixture of Google, Amazon, and Apple devices if you want. You have easy user-friendly dashboards for your family to access the smart home, then you yourself is like the IT admin using Home Assistant to manage and monitor the setup. So that's all. This is seriously the best advice I can share with y'all. I'm not holding back or hiding any secrets here. For me, I used Google Home at stage 1, then I moved to SmartThings for a couple of years. Just a few months back, I managed to move everything to Home Assistant. Right now for me, I'm just slowly fine-tuning and trying out what other stuff Home Assistant can do. Hope this video gives you a better idea on the different smart home systems. Thanks for watching. This will be my last video for this year. I'll see you in 2024. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Bye.